up to this point, the concept of time has not been a factor. Thermodynamics will tell us whether or not a reaction is spontaneous, but it will not tell us how rapidly it occurs. Chemical kinetics will allow us to calculate the rate at which reactants are converted into products. The rate of a reaction is described as the change in concentration per unit time, or moles per liter per second, or molar per second. Assuming the reaction proceeds in the forward direction, the change in concentration of a reactant is negative, as it is being depleted, while that of the product is positive, as it is being generated. To get a positive value when monitoring the concentration of a reactant, we put a negative sign before it. Finally, so as to get the same value for all reactants and products, it is understood that we normalize all of the rates by dividing each by its corresponding stoichiometric coefficient in the balanced equation. The rate of a reaction can be expressed as a function of the concentrations of the reactants and a rate constant, K. We call this expression the rate law. In general, the exponents in the rate law can either be 0, 1, or 2. If the exponent is 0, this means that a change in the concentration of that particular reactant will have absolutely no effect on the reaction rate. If the exponent is 1, then the effect of the reactant's concentration is linear. In other words, if we increase or decrease its concentration by a factor x, then the reaction rate will increase or decrease by that same factor x. If the exponent is 2, then the effect of the reactant's concentration is quadratic. In other words, if the concentration were to, say, triple, the reaction would proceed 9 times faster. Theoretically, different exponents are possible, but in this course, we will limit ourselves to 0, 1, and 2. Finally, when the exponent is 0, 1, or 2 for a reactant, we say that the reaction is 0th, 1st, or 2nd order with respect to that reactant. Experimentally, the rate law can be determined through a series of experiments with known initial concentrations and measured initial reaction rates. As any reactant can affect the reaction rate, it is important to have trials where only one of the concentrations is varied. In this way, we can identify its influence on the reaction rate. In the attached example, we will try to find the influence of reactants A, B, and C on the rate of reaction. Sequentially, we identify data points where only A changes, only B changes, and only C changes. For reactant A, we see that A's influence is non-existent, as doubling A has no influence on the reaction rate. For reactant B, we see that B's influence is quadratic, as increasing B's concentration by a factor of 5 makes the reactant go 25 times faster. Finally, C's influence is linear, as increasing C's concentration by a factor of 3 makes the reaction go 3 times faster. Therefore, the reaction is of 0th order with respect to A, 2nd order with respect to B, and 1st order with respect to C. Its overall order is said to be 3rd order, the sum of all the reactants' individual orders. Finally, the rate constant can be determined by taking any one of the data points and plugging in all of the concentrations and the rate to determine K's value. The units of the rate constant are such that the reaction rate comes out in molar per second.